Hey everybody, it's me, Just Keith, back with a brand new video, and it's finally time I made this video, because I've been having a lot to say and talk about. So, 1,000 Pound Sisters Season 5 ended. Two weeks ago now. And it ended just as I expected it would to. They ended it with Caleb's death. This memorial service that Tammy's family threw for him, for her. Before we get to that, I'm going to quickly go over what happened in the two episodes before. So this video is, we're going to recap like the last three episodes. Okay. So episode 7, the family goes on vacation. And the vacation was fun and everything. But of course there was a lot of tension with Amy. She decides she's gonna drive 9-10 hours from Georgia to Florida. I believe they're from Georgia. I may be wrong on that. It might be. I also have Tennessee in my head, but I don't think it's Tennessee. I'm not sure. So she rides with Amanda's son and Gage and Glenn. They ride like 12 hours to get to Florida with the kids screaming in the car and stuff. So she gets there late. Everybody else flew. Tammy flew on a plane for the first time, which was cool. Also, sorry about the way I sound. I'm very stuffed up. I'm very stopped up right now, but I have a very stuffy nose, so sorry about that, I apologize. So all of them, Tammy, Chris, Amanda, Misty, you know, they took a plane, they get there, you know, they get in the Airbnb, and they everything went away, and they're enjoying their time there, and Amy arrives, like, late at night, so the next morning, they get ready to go to the beach. And they head to the beach, and already kind of like Amanda is kind of annoyed with Amy already, because in the morning when Amy gets up, they had let her sleep in. So it was about 11 or something when she got up, right? And they're all sitting outside, you know, and she comes in. Chris makes a comment. I think it was Chris makes a comment saying like, he's like, well, look who decided to show up, sleepyhead, or something like that. And he's just like, you try taking care of two boys all night. And they got to Amanda. Amanda's just shaking her head. And then, like, in her interview, she's saying, like, telling everybody, like, that it was her and Tammy that were taking care of the boys while Amy was resting. And yeah. So they go to the beach and they have like a fun time, right? They have a blast. They're having fun. Watching them at the beach was really cool. And then like right after, they decide to go to a restaurant. And that's where things in the episode kind of like took a turn, because the boys were so cranky, especially Gage. And here's the thing, like, the episode showed them at the beach, and then it showed them, you know, at the beach, they showed them going to the restaurant. No, they had changed clothes and stuff, but watching it, I always wondered, like, Okay, did they just like, did they change like at the beach and then go to the restaurant? Or did they go back to the Airbnb, change over there, and then go to the restaurant? Because the boy was cranky from being sleepy. Like, I felt like it was good they went to the beach and stuff, you know, to burn out the boy's energy. But I feel like they should have gone. Like, if they immediately went to the restaurant after, that was a bad idea. I feel like they should have gone back to their Airbnb, let the rest up for a while, let those boys rest up for a while until they're hungry, and then go to the restaurant. But that's just me. But yeah, the boys were cranky, like I said, especially Gage. Amanda takes Gage and tries to calm him down, and he's basically, you know, like, you know, throws arms all around, twisting and turning stuff, and she does not need to be picking up any little babies right now, any big babies either, any toddlers, especially ones that flail around like that, you know, because she just had surgery and all that. So she decides to take him back to the Airbnb and like skip dinner, and Amy goes with her and takes Glenn. And that's kind of where the episode ended. And episode 8, like, continues on with the vacation. And that's this one. Oh my God. Everything going on with Amy this season finally came to a head. Like, she had her breaking point in this episode. And this episode was fun. They're doing a little vacation stuff. Chris did the I can't think of the name of it right now, but you know, when you got the parachute hooked up to you and you got the rope hooked up to the boat and the boat's pulling you and you know you're in there. He did that. Which also looked really fun. I think I would do that. I think I would do that. I think that would be fun. And besides that, in the fight, I don't remember too much about the episode. I just thought that was really cool. So yeah, as the episode comes towards the end, Amy just gets like, she gets like upset, you know. When people ask her if she's done this, if she's done that or not, and like I get that, but you know, you gotta realize that when people like when people do that sometimes, it's not because they don't think you haven't done it. You know, it's just 'cause they don't know, and it's just like it's like Tammy said, we're going down a checklist. Okay, did we do this? Did you do that? Did you do that? You know, checking every little thing. Because you have to, and then when you realize you've done everything, that's when you got like, okay, I gotta do something different to calm down. This is where they were asking her, the kids are crying, and they're asking her if she's done this and this, and she gets mad at Tammy. And then she decides, like, she's just yelling at everybody, decides that she's gonna leave, and she's trying to get Amanda's son to get up and take her. And Amanda's like, no, he's not driving you 12 hours, like, in the middle of the night. She even talked about calling Michael to come get him. But, like, I don't think, I don't know. Maybe he would have. Maybe he would have, I don't know. But, and then she just attacked Amanda. That was insane. She was, apparently she was biting. Like, she just started throwing hands and biting and grabbing at Amanda. And, oh my gosh, they had actually had a, had they had actually the producers had to separate everybody, so yeah, that was crazy. And so finally going into the last episode. Oh. So Amy feels guilty about what happened in Florida and everything. And her and Tammy have a discussion and all this stuff. And Amy kind of realizes that she needs to work on things. And she talks about she's starting therapy. So, not soon after Amy and Tammy's conversation about what happened in Florida, Tammy gets devastating news that Caleb passed away. And I knew this is how this season was going to end it. It did not surprise me at all. And so the rest of the episode is pretty much just them being there for Tammy. And they threw together a memorial service for Caleb. Tammy's family did for her. Just kind of honor him. And I think it was like two of Caleb's best friends. Or I think maybe one of them might have been one of his brothers. I don't remember exactly. They were there. And they had a beautiful service. And everything. And it was nice. I don't agree with a lot of the comments I've seen about people talking about Tammy. Like, people calling him a creep and a stalker. I don't think he was perfect. I think he had his faults. In fact, I've said that countless of times in the last two videos I did. I feel like Caleb's biggest issue that he had was he put too much of his belief and faith in somebody else. Like, he couldn't do anything unless Tammy was there. Like, he didn't believe in himself. And, you know, I think if he had believed in himself, things would have been differently. He'd still be alive. That's just my opinion. But yeah, I think Caleb had a good soul. I think he was a decent person. Seemed like a decent person. But yeah, I mean, and there's some rumors apparently saying that like she planned to divorce him before she found out about his death. I don't know if that's true. Not true. I don't really get into that whole like aspect of it. Of like, I like watching a show, but I don't really go like looking at things, you know, what's going on with them currently. I've done a little bit just like for these videos, but yeah, to me that's all gossip to me. And while gossip is always fun, I don't really go looking for it. But yeah, the service was beautiful. They had some moments that were kind of a little silly. There was a part where they decided to release some butterflies. And so they had a box, okay? And they opened up the box. And for a second, I thought, OMG, those butterflies are dead. They weren't. It was only like five of them. But yeah, they released the butterflies and they kind of terrorized people a little bit. So that was fun. And then later on, Tammy kind of did her own thing. Where she released one of those balloon lantern things. Which we've done before. Those are fun. Especially like lighting them. That's always fun, yeah. And, you know, just to move on. So, yeah, this season has been really crazy. It's, like, all the stuff we've seen with, like, Tammy has been so great. Like, all the little small, like, triumphs. And, like, you know, even seeing, like, you know, our siblings be proud of her little small triumphs. Like, we was rewatching an episode, like, earlier this season, like, maybe, like, second or third episode or something. Chris was taking Amy somewhere. Chris was taking Tammy somewhere. And she rode in the front seat for her first time. And he was just saying, like, you know, it's so great seeing how, like, she triumphs over that. Because, you know, it's just a front seat. But to Tammy, getting in that front seat now is, like, the greatest victory ever. And she kept having victories this season. And Amy, I really hope she got everything figured out. Oh, so, going back to this last episode, I almost forgot to mention something because I thought this was the most hilarious part of the episode. So, at one point in the episode, Amy gets, like, some papers in the mail. It's, like, her divorce finalized and everything and all that. And, like, you know, who gets what and all this stuff. So, they get, like, shared custody of the kids, right? She gets the house and some stuff. Michael gets the car. And I think he got the TV. And then he got the lawnmower. I was like, and I had to rewind it. I'm like, okay, because what called Melkor was the lawn. He got the lawnmower in the divorce. I don't know why that's so funny to me. I don't know. But that's just hilarious. So yeah, there was a lot of drama with Amy this season. It really, like, and a lot of people have said this, it really feels like Amy and Tammy kind of switched up. Because before Tammy went to that hospital. Oh, hey girl, I didn't even know you was under me. Before she went to the rehab place and everything, there was a lot of drama. Like, I used to hate watching the show, but I'd watch it anyway. You ever done that? You ever had a show that, like, you hate watching? Like, there's somebody on the show that you don't like, because it's like, they could be the personality, it could be their attitude, it could be the way they treat people. And Tammy used to be just the worst, like, and I really didn't like her personality in the first couple seasons. But when she started going to this rehab place and started kind of getting more serious and, you know, believing herself more, I was like, okay, Tammy, I see you. You got a good, there's a good soul in there. And it was a new season started. It's like they switched. So now, like, Tammy's, you know, kind of more like logical, reasonable one, you know, if it, you know, step away from the situation and everything. And Amy just tagging people, like, people who are trying to help her. And I say it's frustrating when you're doing all that you can do and then you have people, like, asking you if you've done everything. But, you know, if it's people that you know or at least trying to help you in all way and not, like, being condescending towards you, that's different. But yeah, this was a great season. I hope we get another one. Can't see what happens next. It's gonna be cool. So guys, I hope you all enjoyed the video. Please drop a like, leave a comment down below, and I'll see you all in the next one. Love you guys.